Welcome for analysis of our second paper, that is ancient history paper. One request is there that there should be question paper in your hand. Then only you can observe this video meaningfully, or you must be aware of the questions. So first go through question paper and then observe this analysis. So question number one, total 25 questions we have to discuss. Which of the following statement is not true? So when we are reading out this way, we have to get alert. The statement which is not true, that means false statement, you have to mark. There are total four statements, so there must be pen or pencil, something in your hand, and you can mark true and false. Follow this method that while writing only, you have to mark T or F. So here, at Gudimalla Lingam, difficult to pronounce, just check out. At Gudimalla Lingam, there is Lord Shiva temple built in Satvahan style. So this statement is true. This place is somewhere near Chennai, in vicinity of Chennai. I don't know, but whatever I read, that only I am telling out. And this is considered as mysterious place because there is only one temple that is built in Satvahan style. No other matching monument is there in the vicinity. Usually what happens, that when any structure, say for example, if you are visiting out Badami, that is Vatapipuram, then that is in Karnataka. So nearby that, you'll have Patakkal, Aihole, so like that, various places showing similar thing. So here, there is only one standing temple. Maybe possible other temples must have destroyed in the time gap, or only one temple is constructed, we don't know about it. So that Gudimalla Lingam, there is Lord Shiva temple that is built in Satvahan style, statement is true. Pulakeshi II defeated Arab invaders in sea. Answer, that is also true. After establishment of Islam, in order to spread that religion, Arab invaders tried to attack on Pulakeshi, that means Chalukya Empire, and twice they attacked by sea route, whereas in naval battle they were defeated. Death place of Chandragupta Maurya is at Shravana Belagola. So this is also true. According to Jain tradition, whatever the literature available, that at end of life, that means actually at mid of life, Chandragupta accepted Jainism, and then he left out his empire, went far to the south side from his empire, that is in Karnataka. Karnataka was not part of his empire at his time, most probably, and therefore he left out and went into jungles of Karnataka. There is a sacred place that is called as Shravana Belagola. You must have aware about the Bahubali. So that Bahubali idol, that is also there at Shravana Belagola. And a surprising thing is there, that one of the Marathi inscription that is found under that Bahubali idol, it is considered as first Marathi inscription found over there, that is Ye Chamundaraye Kalviyale. So like that, old ancient Marathi script, that is inscription that is found over there. So Chandragupta Maurya, he went to that Shravana Belagola and died there. That is according to Jain tradition. That is, we have to meditate in this way, that ultimately you have to live even food and water also. And only we have to consume air. And like that, that is called as a sort of self-starvation. But that is according to people like us. According to Jain tradition, it is high class, the stage of a human being. So that is the Chandragupta Maurya's death place. So as all three statements given here are true, and there should be one at least false statement. So logically, fourth statement is false. Let us verify. Pulakeshi II was whom ruler? So this is only wrong. Pulakeshi II was Chalukya ruler, and ruling from South India, its capital was Vatapipuram, that is called as Badami, who accepted Hinduism and ruling from Ujjain. So all this statement is completely wrong. So answer here is D. Which of the following statement, second question, which of the following statement is true? Now check out, first we put out not true, second true. That means we have to find out only true statement. All caves at Ajanta are Hinayan Buddhist caves. Answer, yes. It is true, it is false, because at Ajanta we are getting Hinayana as well as Mahayana Buddhist caves. How to distinguish between Hinayana and Mahayana? So Hinayana that is original form of Buddhism, where worship of Lord Buddha is not there. Instead of that, there is only stupa in the cave. So if you found only stupa in the cave, then that is Hinayana. But if idol of Lord Buddha is there, then it is called as Mahayana cave. So if you visit out Ajanta, many caves are having stupa. But many caves, they don't have only stoop. Apart from that, they have idol of Lord Buddha in various designs, decorated paintings, everything. Lord Buddha and life of Lord Buddha is depicted over there. So all caves in Hina, Ajanta are Hinayana. It is wrong. Some of the caves, then answer is true. Then something mysterious part is also there, because on stupa, Lord Buddha idol is also carved out. So like that stupa, they are also observed. Now, second, Kushan Emperor Vimkar Faisic was patron of Mahayana Buddhism. Buddhism is having two sects, Hinayana and Mahayana. Out of that, Mahayana Buddhism was developed and got tremendous influence during Kushan Emperor Kanishka, who was descendant of Vimkar Faisic. And so obviously Mahayana Buddhism was not popular at time of Vimkar Faisic to that extent, and so he was not Mahayana Buddhism. Kanishka accepted Buddhism, that is Mahayana Buddhism. It is said that Mahayana Buddhism was practiced out in Andhra Pradesh or Telangana in very primitive style, that was patronized by Kanishka, and then onwards Mahayana Buddhism was popularized all over the world. Now, national emblem. So first statement is false, second statement is false. Let us check out C. That is national emblem of today's India. Why it is mentioned as today's India? Because time to time that can change. So today's India is adopted from Sarnath. Yes, a stupa is there at Sarnath, which is constructed by great emperor Ashoka. And from that, there is a pillar that is called as Ashoka Stambha. And that we are adopting out. So this statement is true. So obviously DK's statement must be false, but let us verify. Bhaje caves are carved out during rule of Krishna II of Rashtrakuta dynasty. Now, Bhaje caves are ancient most caves in Deccan Plateau. Primitive style of caves. So, there is a complex of three caves, that is Bhaje, Karla and Bedsa, in nearby area, in vicinity of 10 km only. So, out of that, the Bhaje is supposed to be very, very ancient. We believe that at least 200 years BC is the period of this Bhaje caves. Obviously, at that time, Kushans were not there in India, and these caves are being Buddhist caves. They are having carvings, that is only stupa. No Lord Buddha idol is there, so they are all Hinayana caves. But Bhaje caves are carved out around 200 BC, whereas Krishna II of Rashtrakuta dynasty was ruling somewhere in range of AD. 700 AD onwards, and therefore this statement is false. So A, B, C, out of that C is correct. A, B and D, three statements are wrong. Now, correctly matched pair, we have to find out. There should be some relationship. It is not necessary that always all pairs should have same relationship, but connectivity must be there, which is relevant connectivity. So which pair is, but it is said not correctly matched. So we have to find out correctly match and not correctly match. So write down true and false again. So Veda Brahmavadini. Now you may say that it is spelling mistake, but I am always having doubt that why we have to pronounce as Veda. It is Veda. Sanskrit word is there, that is Veda. It is problem of Roman script that we can't pronounce perfectly. So what spellings we have made, that is according to pronunciation theory. So Veda, that is connected with Brahmavadini. So Brahmavadini are the women, those are considered as prophet, that is called as Drashta. If male person is there, then he is called as Drashta. If female is there, then that is called as Brahmavadini. So Vedic literature is composed not only by male, women were also contributed a lot. These women are called as Brahmavadini. So Vedas and Brahmavadini, they are connected with each other. So A statement is match. Statement B, Atharva Veda, and that word is Angirasa. It is not misspelled. It is Angirasa. So Angiras is again drashta or prophet of Atharvaveda. Two prophets were there, Atharvana and Angiras. That's why many times Atharvaveda is also called as Atharvangiras. So this pair is also correctly matched. Then Upanishad and something is written that is called as Chandogya. This is also true because there are many Upanishad. This is Vedic literature only, part of Vedanta Samhita. So where we are getting Upanishad, one of the name of Upanishad is Chandogya Upanishad. So Chandogya is name of Upanishad, therefore this is also perfectly matched. That is answer is D. Shata Sahasri Samhita. This is actually name of Mahabharata. In next question we are going to discuss this. So this is Shata Sahasri Samhita, that is Mahabharata, which is not at all connected with Banabhatta. You are aware that Banabhatta was in court of Harshavardhan, Emperor Harshavardhan. At that time Banabhatta was present, whereas Mahabharata was from ancient period, we believe that at least 5000 years ago. So anyway, Shata Sahasri Samhita and Banabhatta is not match one, so answer is D. Which of the following is not arranged chronologically? So where we have to go now, chronologically. Chronologically means the ancient most should be first and newest should be at last. So first option, Mahabharata, Ramayana, Veda, Shata Sahasri Samhita. So what is the correct sequence actually? That it should be Veda first, the ancient most literature in the world. Some people are claiming it is Zen Avesta, but according to our tradition, we claim that it is Veda. So Veda, then it is Ramayana, then Mahabharata, and Mahabharata means only Shata Sahasri Samhita. So this first only is not arranged chronologically. Second, Veda, it's true, ancient. Then Jaya, what we are saying that Mahabharata was written by Vyas, Maharishi Vyas, but practically Maharishi Vyas composed a book that is comprising of nearly 8000 shloka, that is called as Jaya, which is, we can say, the essence of that Mahabharata that is composed by Maharishi Vyas, that is only Jaya. After that, Vaishampayan is name of sage who expanded that Jaya to 24,000 shloka, and that's why it is called as and he renamed it. He is not saying the name of literature as Jaya. He considered a different name based on that Jaya. So that name is Bharata. After that, Sauti is name of another sage. Along with Sauti, his disciples, all of them expanded this 24,000 shloka to 1 lakh shloka. So 1 lakh, that is 100,000. In Sanskrit, it is called as Shata Sahasra. So Shata Sahasri Samhita. So this type of name was given to the book, that is Shata Sahasri Samhita, where people started calling it Mahabharata instead of calling this huge name. What Jaya was there, Jaya onwards Bharat, then it is Mahabharata instead of Shata Sahasri Samhita. But original name of book is Shata Sahasri Samhita. So this is the correctly matched sequence B. Then C, Veda, then Upanishad, yes, then Jaya. And now last thing we are discussing about, that is called as Darshan Vangmay. So Vaisheshik Darshan, Darshan literature is there. In that Darshan literature, there is some prophet of each literature. So the prophet of Vaisheshik Darshan is having name as Aulukya. We don't know exact period, but from 200 BC to nearly 400 AD, different periods are there for this Vaisheshik Darshan. Prophet of this Vaisheshik Darshan is called as Aulukya. He put forward theory in that Vaisheshik Darshan that everything in this universe is manifestation of small particle, and he termed that small particle as Anu. And that's why he was called as Kanad. You must aware of this sage, that in chemistry we discuss Indian chemistry from Kanad onwards. So this Kanad, that is the person, his original name is Aulukya, So this sequence is also correctly matched. If we are saying it is 200 BC or 400 AD, then also it is coming to the end period. Panchatantra, Malavika Agni Mitram, Harsha Charitra, Raja Tarangini. Now this is also correctly matched, as we discussed that oath. Option A is only from our side it is correct, but not correctly matched. So not arranged chronologically. So D is also right sequence. Panchatantra, according to belief, it was also composed somewhere 200 BC. Then Malavika Agni Mitram, Panchatantra was given by Vishnu Sharma. Then Malavika Agni Mitram is a drama which is composed by a great poet Kalidas, and it is based on Agni Mitra. You most aware of that history, that after end of Maurya dynasty, Shunga dynasty started ruling over Magad. Pushyamitra Shunga rebelled out, the general of Maurya, Brihadrath Maurya was assassinated and Pushyamitra Shunga took the charge. So son of Pushyamitra Shunga was Agni Mitra, and the drama is based on Agni Mitra. So Malavika Agni Mitram. Next, Harsha Charita. So that is written by Bana Bhatta. And last, Raja Tarangini. The Raja Tarangini is the book from which we derived much of the Indian history from ancient period. It is composed by Kallan. In bracket, they are mentioning out Billan. Why, I don't know. But that Kallan from Kashmir, he wrote this book that is called as Raja Tarangini. And he reported various dynasties in this book. So this is considered nowadays as a standard book to study out Indian history in ancient period, what it was. So this is somewhere in 11th, 12th century. So these are books are there arranged. Now next thing, the Shak era began in the year. So Shak era, you can check out today also. Whatever the CE, that is common era or Christian era, from that we have to subtract 78 years. You will get what Shak era present today. So that means it must have started around 78 AD. So today also we are living in 20th century of Shak era. Alright, because it is 78 years back. So it started at 78 AD. Answer is D. But see the confusion. It is put as B option, 78 BC. So if you are having concept in mind, 78, maybe possible there is chance of trap between BC and AD. So keep in mind it is 78 AD. The title Vikramaditya was assumed by many Indian emperors, assumed this title, but in the list given, the title is assumed by Chandragupta II. He was son of Samudragupta, and he defeated and crushed down Shak power, that is Saka or Shaka, that is Scythian power in India. And after destruction of Scythian power, he carried out sacrifice and he took two titles. One is called as Shakari, that is enemy of Shak people, and second, that is Vikramaditya. Kanishka patronized. So as earlier discussed, that Kanishka patronized Mahayana Buddhism. There are three sects in Buddhism prominently. They are Mahayana Buddhism, Hinayana Buddhism, and Vajrayana. Mahayana Buddhism following the idolatry, that is idol worshipping of Lord Buddha. Whereas Hinayana Buddhism, they following original principles of Buddhism given by Lord Buddha. Whereas Vajrayana, they are similar to Hatha Yoga practice in Vedic religion. And Bhagavatism, that is worshipping of Lord Sri Krishna and Vishnu. So Kanishka patronized Mahayana Buddhism. Harsha, that is Harshavardhan from Harsha dynasty, moved his capital from dash dash to dash dash. Answer is Thanesar to Kanauj. And Kanauj become prominent center in ancient India. Actually, the credit goes to Kushan Emperor Kanishka. The reason is that he considered Kanauj as his second capital, whereas Kanauj was emerged out as new trade center, dominating trade center during Kanishka's rule, because what Silk Route was going on from Europe to China, that was connected by Kanishka, because it was part of Kanishka's empire at that time in between, and so it was connected, and Indian trade developed along with that Silk Route. pick odd one out. Ninth question, actually it is repeated question. Next time also this question is there. Pick out odd one, Samprati, Kunal, Brihadrath and Bimbisar. So Samprati, Kunal and Brihadrath, all three are Mauryan emperors. Magar empire only, but Mauryan empire after the Ashoka the Great. Whereas Bimbisar is first known Magar emperor, father of Ajatashatru, that is Haryanka dynasty. And that's why we have to odd one as Bimbisar. Don't get confused with Bindusar, the son of Chandragupta Maurya. Alright, next. Bhadbhatta lived in court of, obviously, just we discussed now that he was in court of Harshavardhana. Harshacharita was written by Bhadbhatta. The Chola king ruled over northern part of India is, the answer is Rajendra Chola, option A. Rajendra Chola, a great Chola king ruling from Tanjavur as his capital, occupied Gangetic Plain and then took his title as Gangai Konda Chola. That means the Chola who ruled over Ganga Plain. And then he shifted his capital from Tanjavur to a new capital developed by him on his name only, that is called as Gangai Konda Chola Puram. So this is Chola king ruled over northern part. 12th question, the earliest inscription that is one official record in Sanskrit is, so that answer is Junagadh rock inscription. It's surprised to know that this Junagadh rock inscription is in Sanskrit, but carved out where by Scythian rulers, Shak ruler, where achievements of Rudradaman are mentioned over there. A principal patron of the Gandhar school of art, where the the question should be what's, only one answer is there. So they were Kushan, as Mahayana was developed during Kushan period. The idol of Lord Buddha was carved out initially because capital of Kushan Empire was at Pushpapur or Purushpur, that is Peshawar. And so that is there, Kushan is right answer. Kunal Maurya, 14th question. Kunal Maurya was emperor who spread Jainism in Central Asia. Kunal Maurya is right. He was emperor, but he was Buddhist. So there is no question of spreading Jainism in Central Asia. And so first statement is false. Whereas Ashok was patron of Buddhism who defeated Kharwel in Punjab. Now first clause is true, that Ashok was patron of Buddhism, but he defeated Kharwel in Punjab is wrong. So Kharwel was Jain emperor, but after many years, after Ashok. And so this statement is false. So both statements are false. Question is asked, which of the following statement is correct? And answer is none of the above is correct. 15th, Battle of Hydaspes was fought between Alexander and Porus. True. Hydaspes river is now called as Shatadru. False. Now it is called as Jhelum. In Sanskrit, in ancient period, its name was Vitasta. So, both first statement is true, second is false. What is asked, which statement is correct? And answer is only one. Find odd one. This is repeated question. Bindusara, Bimbisara, Samprati and Kunal. So, Bindusara, Samprati and Kunal, they were Mauryan emperors. Whereas Bimbisara was Haryanka dynasty, first known emperor. So, obviously answer is B. 17. Menander, Pushyamitra, Shunga, Brihadrath, Maurya and Kanishka. This is just doubtful. Because Menander was Greek, Pushyamitra, Shunga was Indian, Brihadrath, Maurya was Indian, but Kanishka is again Kushan. So I can't apply the term Indian and non-Indian. Now religion wise, yes, Menander, Buddhist. So initially, I don't know what was his religion, but in India, he accepted Buddhism. Pushyamitra, Shunga following Vaidikism. Brihadrath, Maurya following Buddhism. Kanishka, I don't know initial religion, but after that he accepted Mahayana Buddhism, that means Buddhism. So here we can go by this way, that Menander, Brihadrath, Maurya and Kanishka, all three were Buddhist, whereas Pushyamitra Shunga was non-Buddhist. So we can give answer as B, Pushyamitra Shunga. If you are going by capital, then Pushyamitra Shunga and Brihadrath Maurya both were having capital at Pataliputra. Menander was having capital at Sialkot initially, but he was not able to reach till Pataliputra, and Kanishka was also not able to reach till Pataliputra. So there is no question of capital. 18th, Vardhaman Mahavir was the first Jain Tirthankar, false. First Jain Tirthankar is called as Rishabhadeva, or he is called as Adinath, the first prophet of Jainism. Whereas Parshvanath was actually 23rd Tirthankar of Jainism. So from Rishabhadeva to Parshvanath, they are all Tirthankars who reveled out religion. 23rd Tirthankar, that is Parshvanath, edited all this literature. Whereas Vardhaman Mahavir, a Lichhavi prince who converted, who meditated and then spread out Jainism, so he was 24th Tirthankar. So both statements here are not correct. So answer is none of above, answer D. 19. Eightfold path was given by Parshvanath for Jainism. No. Eightfold path was given by Lord Buddha in Buddhism. Middle path was given in Buddhism. Yes. This is not extreme towards, we can say, Virakti, and extreme towards Asakti. Virakti means having all, we have to left everything. Asakti means attract, getting attached somewhere. So middle path is prominence of Buddhism, and that's why it is said that Buddhism flourished out in initial stages. So that is the answer. So here the first is wrong, but second is true. So which statement is correct? Answer is only two. Now 20th question, according to Rock Edict 13 of Ashoka the Great, Antiochus, that is Antiochus II, was ruler of Syria. Yes, it is true that they have references in Rock Edict, and accordingly it is true. Whereas during rule of Gondopharnes, India first came into contact with Christianity. This statement is also true, because at that time the disciples of Jesus Christ, they were traveling across the world, and then they reached in the court of Gondopharnes, who was ruling in region of Indus. So at that time India came in contact with Christianity first. So both statements are true. 21st statement, in Nadeghat inscription in Sanskrit, King Rudradaman's achievements were highlighted. Nadeghat is in Maharashtra, Sahyadri mountain range, where Satvahan king, Gautamiputra Satkarni's achievements were highlighted, and that is not Rudradaman's, and so statement is false. Moga or Maus is name of first Yavan ruler of India. No, his first invader, who is Scythian invader, Shak or Shak invader, invaded from Bolan Pass in Balochistan. So both statements are false. So answer question is asked, which of the statement is true? Answer is D. Tripitakas are sacred book of the. So this is called as Pitaka, means baskets. So Tripitaka, three baskets, that is sacred book of Buddhist. So answer is D. Old coin found in northwest India is showing year of minting as 320 BC in Greek language. It may belong to Alexander. Obviously 320 BC is period of Alexander. Chandragupta, yes, he is contemporary of Alexander according to present history. Gautamiputra Satkarni, no question, because Gautamiputra Satkarni is around 78 AD. So doubt is there between A and B. Whereas D option is totally outstanding. It is a fake coin. And I hope D option is the correct option, because what is BC? That is before Christ. So Alexander or Chandragupta, both of them, I admire their greatness, but they were not aware that after 320 years, Lord Christ will be there. Jesus Christ will be there. And therefore, how they can mint on their coin as 320 BC. Okay. And therefore, this is a fake coin. 24th, oldest Ved. So amongst the Ved, Rigved is comprised first. According to scholars, it was comprising since 1000 years. It took place to comprise entire Vedic, Rigvedic Samhita, that is literature. So this is the ancient old Ved. Whereas 25th question, dash dash Ved is delegated for Indian music. The answer is Samaveda is delegated for Indian music. So this is all about the discussion. If you have any doubt, you can put forward that doubt into comment box. You can make comment. We will try to answer and try to solve that doubt. Thanks.